Hello and welcome to the computed tomography section of the biomedical imaging course. I am Dr. Karine Mardon. In this video, we will cover a brief overview of the history of this technology. The development of medical equipment, such as computed tomography scanners, also called CT scanner, happened in the mid-1950s. It has initiated a big step forward in the field of diagnostic imaging. With this new technology, we can look inside a human body, slice by slide, without using a scalpel. The CT has benefited from the discovery of X-ray with the development of new mathematical algorithms, allowing the reconstruction of an image of any given cross-section of a human body. The accidental discovery of the radiation, known today as X-ray radiation, was made in 1895 by the German scientist Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen. He was a professor of physics at the University of Würzburg, and here is a photo of his lab where he discovered X-ray radiation. He was awarded the Nobel Prize of Physics in 1901. 2 years later, in 1897, William Morton was the first person to take a picture of a whole skeleton using X-ray. However, the initial excitement surrounding the diagnostic possibilities of X-ray did not last long. Scientists soon realized the limitation of body imaging in two dimensions. In 1916, Dr. Carol Meyer obtained images using a moving X-ray tube and a stationary film cassette, a method close to the process of scanning by computed tomography. But the discovery of X-ray in itself was not sufficient to the creation of computed tomography. CT invention was very much dependent on the development of computational technique. So, without the combination of X-ray and the progress in computed technology, computed tomography will not exist today. In 1979, two scientists received the Nobel Prize of Physiology and Medicine, Cormac, and Godfrey Hounsfield created computed tomography. In 1971, two neurologists, James Ambrose and Louis Quill, tested a prototype scanner, the EMI Mark I scanner. This prototype was an head scanner. The system was installed at an hospital in Wimbledon in the UK, and the CT scanner at that time were known as EMI scanners. 2 years later, in 1973, the first commercial CT scanner was on the market. It was called the EMI CT1000. From 1974 to 1976, companies started to develop and sell CT scanners, and the competition was fierce. For example, Neuroscan developed a head scanner and Disco a whole body scanner. Then bigger companies such as Technicare and General Electric quickly took a major share of the scanner market. In Europe, manufacturers such as Siemens and Philips also produced CT scanner at that time. In 1976, the first fan beam scanners was developed. The fan-shaped radiation beam covers a larger part of the patient body. The gantry, this part of the body here highlighted by an arrow, will spin 360 degrees in one direction and take an image, then spin 360 degrees back in the other direction to take a second image. However, between each image, the gantry will stop. It will then reverse direction, with the patient table will be moved forward. So actually, scanning time will take very long. In 1989, the first spiral or helical CT scanner was developed. An innovation called the slip ring allowed electric power to be transferred from a stationary power source onto a gantry, which now rotates non-stop. CT scanner with the slip rings can rotate constantly and do not have to start and stop. Scanning has become a lot faster. From 1989 to 2004, a new type of CT scanner was developed again, the multi-slices spiral CT scanner. The beam of radiation took the shape of a cone. This was the start of three-dimensional projection techniques. By combining the cone beam and the spiral motion, scanning time was even shorter. With one major benefit, the artifact caused by patient motions, such as breathing, were greatly reduced. If you are going for a CT scan, it is likely that you will be scanned with a CT scanner using 64 rows of X-ray detectors, also called 64 slice CT. However, the newer scanner has now a 320 row detector. Like this instrument, the Aquilion 1 is the world's first dynamic volume CT imaging system that enables acquiring entire organs with one volume scan, one rotation. Imaging a larger area of the body at one time is now possible, and the scan takes only 200 of milliseconds. As you can see, the CT has really changed in less than 40 years.